teach you a lesson or two, Mr. Bailey.
Yes, sir.
Send Bailey in.
Right away, sir. Mr. Bailey, Mr. Potter will see you now.
Thank you.
Ah, oh, good morning, Georgie. It's so good to see you again.
Mr. Potter? This is quite an unusual request.
What's that?
You asking me to pay you a visit.
I don't know what's so unusual about it. I just thought it was time that the two of us get better acquainted. Here, have a cigar.
Oh, no thank you, Mr. Potter. I don't smoke.
All right, George, please, have a seat.
Oh, thank you. Now, I know I'll find out sooner or later, but just why exactly did you ask me here, Mr. Potter?
Now, that's just what I like so much about you. George, I'm an old man, and most people hate me, but I don't like them either, so that makes it all even. You know just as well as I do that I run practically everything in Bedford Falls, but the Bailey Building and Loan. You know also that for a number of years now, I've been trying to get control of it. Or to kill it. But I haven't been able to do it. You have been stopping me. In fact, you've beaten me, George. And as anybody in this county can tell you, that takes some doing. Take during the Depression, for instance. You and I were the only ones who kept our heads. You saved the building and loan, and I saved all the rest.
Most people say you stole all the rest.
Ah, the envious ones say that, George, the suckers. Now, I've stated my position very frankly. Let's take a look at your side. Young man, 27, 28, married, making, say, 40 a week.
45.
45? 45. Out of which, after supporting your wife and your mother and paying all your bills, you're able to keep, say, 10 if you scrimp. A child or two comes along and you won't even be able to save the 10. Now, if this young man of 28 were a common, ordinary yokel, I'd say he's doing just fine. But George Bailey is not a common, ordinary yokel. He's an intelligent, smart, ambitious young man who hates his job, who hates the building and loan almost as much as I do. A young man who's been dying to get out on his own ever since he was born. A young man, the smartest one of the crowd, mind you, who's had to sit by and watch his friends go places because he's trapped. Yes, sir? Trapped into frittering away his life playing nursemaid to a lot of riffraff. Now, do I paint a correct picture or do I exaggerate?
So what's your point, Mr. Potter?
My point is I want to hire you.
Hire me?
I want you to manage my affairs. George, run my properties. I'll pay you $20,000 a year.
$20,000 a year?
You wouldn't mind living in the nicest house in town? Buying your wife a lot of fine clothes? Maybe a couple of business trips to New York each year? Maybe once in a while to Europe? You wouldn't mind that, would you, George?
Would I? So you're not talking to somebody else around here, are you? This is me. Remember me, George Bailey?
Yes, George Bailey, whose ship has just come in, providing he's got the brains to hop aboard.
Right, now, what about the building and loan?
Oh, confounded man, are you afraid of success? I'm offering you a 3-year contract starting at $20,000 a year. Now, is it a deal or isn't
it? Well, I know I should just jump at the opportunity, Mr. Potter. I'm just wondering if I could have, say, 24 hours to think it over.
Sure, George. You go home and talk it over with your wife.
Yes, I'd like to do that.
And in the meantime, I'll fill out the papers.
All right, Mr. Potter.
Okay, George.
All right.
Mr.
No. I don't have to talk to anybody. I know my answer right now, and it's no, no, doggone it. You sit around here, and you spin your little webs, and you think the whole world revolves around you. Well, it doesn't, Mr. Potter. You know, I'd say in the whole vast configuration of things, you're nothing more than a scurvy little spider. You don't, and that goes for you, too. And it goes for you, too. Merry Christmas, by the way.
Merry Christmas, George. Mr. Bailey, there seems to be a problem here.
What sort of a problem?
George, can I see you for a moment alone?
What's going on? Uncle Billy, what is it?
George.
What?
Oh, dear, is that your bad ear?
No.
That you did hear me.
Yeah, I'm afraid so. All right. How much? Come on. That much? All right. Did you stop to buy anything along the way?
No, nothing. Not even a stick of gum.
Are you sure you even had the money with you?
Yes, I'm sure. I was counting it. I think.
You think? Uncle Billy, we've got to find that money.
Oh, George, I'm no good to you.
Listen to me. Do you have any secret hiding place in your house? Some place you might have put the money to keep it safe?
No, nothing like that.
Listen to me. Think!
I have been thinking, George. I have, and I can't think anymore. It hurts.
Hey, where is that money, you silly, stupid old fool? Do you know what this means? It means scandal and bankruptcy and prison.
No!
Now, that's what it means. One of us is going to jail. It's not going to be me.
Hello, darling.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello. How do you like it?
Bless you.
It looks like...
Did you bring the wreath?
The wreath? What wreath?
The Merry Christmas wreath for the window.
No, I left it at the office.
Is it snowing?
Yeah, it just started.
Well, where's your coat and hat?
I left them at the office.
George, what's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. Everything's all right.